I'll never throw away something you can mend. I'll never throw away something you can mend. Cause your clothes should be a comfort, your clothes should be a friend. I'll never throw away something you can mend. Cause the clothes that I love the best are clothes I've had for years. The clothes that I mended are the holes and rips and tears. And my clothes are full of memories, lessons that I've learned. My clothes are full of wisdom, I didn't buy that, it was earned.
And my clothes... Well, it's time for the next unmasking of Spotty, Spotty Cat. And now I was saying, if I can fall over on camera, it's even better. Anyways, hello from me, and it's hello from...
Me.
That's Sue. And it is hello from Spotty, Spotty Cat. I'll meow for a meow. But she's at leisure somewhere. Anyway, let's get straight into it, Sue.
Yes.
And, okay. And I shall come around this side.
Okay.
And, okay, so, let's start off with the vase, because it's in the middle. This is opaline glass. It's really, really, I love the painting on it. And, everything else, and. This is Victorian. It's poppy on the top. Mm. Everyone loves poppies. I don't know if they're blue cornflowers. Is that supposed to be a lupin? No, it's droopy. But it has got, oh dear, a big whack on it. But it was so cheap. And I guess I love that. But I might love this even more. It's tin art. It's got to be Second World War. It's got a little dent on it. Let's hope that was a... Oh, that was where a bullet must have hit it, Sue. Oh, I guarantee that. Yeah. It could be, though, couldn't it?
Yeah.
And then inside...
Realms of Fantasy.
It's got a complete lining, which is a good thing. It might have some writing up there.
Yes, I got that.
Yeah, I don't know if it's got a date on it. And or a crown. And that's it. Second World War, classic British Army tin hat. Oh, it's got an M down here, Sue. So they came in sizes. I presume this was middle, or is it medium? Yeah. Anyway.
Military.
Yeah, no, I think it's medium, isn't it? So it was obviously a tin hat for a spiritualist. And so let's get into something else completely, completely different. And this is just great. I mean, just in terms of value, what I really like about this, which is stoneware, it's almost in the American style of stoneware with the blue dash painting on it. Really, you know, really solid thing. Good enough to go in your garden. I love the way it's been engineered with the little holes in the bottom. This is a brilliant flower pot.
Yeah,
I know. Isn't that just great? Anyway, I'm gonna plonk my, what do I plonk in these? It's always sedums. Mm. That's in the glazer, is it? And anyway, it's not antique, but it's lovely. I've run out of inventive things to say. It's a flower pot. I'm going to do some cars now. Brum, 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 brum. And 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 brum, brum, brum. The first one is just a Volkswagen. He's nicely made. I think it's a Materi or something, I cannot remember, but it's an Eastern company made in China. Why are VWs so iconic? If ever I see almost anything VW, I pick it up. Might have a little break there. Yeah, this Chinese stuff, it's so good. So let's abandon the little VW and get into these three, which are all Hot Wheels. And when Hot Wheels get into this sort of fantasy craziness, I love them to bits. I don't know what happened with this one. I don't know what's going on there. He appears to be complete, unless he had something coming. No, I think he's probably missing something across there, but I don't know. I'll have to look him up. But these Hot Wheels, I forgot to look at the dates on these. None of them are ancient. This blue one is really odd. He's got door wheels on the back, but he sort of does this as well. And he's great. I love his fantasy. And I think he's definitely all there. And he might have worn off a bit of silver. But my favourite is this one. I don't know what he's called. But again, Hot Wheels are so cheap to pick up. And they are just works of art. They truly, truly are. But out of all the cars I picked, without any doubt, this is my favourite. This is in such ridiculously good nick. It's a Matchbox. I'll turn him over for you, Sue, if you want to try and get in. I guarantee you'll be upside down, will he? Is he a human being? So I'll spin him round.
No, he's a Sue.
Oh, was he the right way up?
Yeah, he was.
Okay. Hillman. Yeah, Leslie Matchbox.
Hillman
and those Link. Original little grey wheels on.
Made in England.
Yeah.
Hillman Imp.
Yeah.
Hillman
Minx.
Minx.
I think that my dad had one of these. In fact, we definitely did. This was our family car, except it wasn't blue. It was beige with a white top. And when we got it, like, you know, about third or fourth hand, we just thought it was the poshest thing ever. But what brilliant condition that is. And that was my little collection of cars. The next thing, I think, very, very quick, I'm going to do is the little butterfly brooch. Now, Costume Julie. It's a butterfly. Mm. He sparkles. He's lovely. This was £1.50 from the Cats Protection. Mm. If you really do get into costume jewellery and makers and the rest of that, one of the easiest things to start looking at is whether or not the little gems are actually claw set, as opposed to like this, where they're just set in.
Just
pasted in. But, you know, butterflies are an emotive image. And I just couldn't resist it anyway. So let's fly the butterfly away.
Neat spelling.
Yeah. And we'll drive the cars away. And so they all parked up okay.
Yeah.
And next thing we got was, skip fodder.
Oh,
this was out of a skip. Still got rubble in it.
Oh, yeah.
I know. And I think he's all brass under there. I don't know if someone painted him, but it looks nice like that, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And hey, if you've still got a coal fire, if you just need something indoors to put things in, or these are lovely in the garden with something planted up inside them. Sue, I think we've got a bit of unpacking to do before we get into the rest. So we'll leave you with a bit of music while we unpack.
When you buy your clothes second hand, when you got time to give your neighbour a helping hand, when you plant a tree on barren land, all that feeling you get, hope you understand, it's cause you just press the green button. Oh, there's no lemon or sesame.
Well, we're unpacked, dear me, what a lot of paper. This tea set came from the Red Cross in Brecon again, and by it there's a lot of it.
And
when you consider that this was £5 for the lot, I didn't realise how much I was getting. It's absolutely incredible. I mean, there are actually, it's a part tea set, you know, oh dear. There's six plates, which probably would have been right. There's the beak sandwich plate. And incidentally, I cannot remember the name of the pattern, but it's totally, totally unmarked and hardly looks used. And good semi-porcelain. It's got its creamer. It's got its little sugar bowl. It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cups. But I think that... did you say there's two there?
Yeah.
Well, it's actually got sauces for all the cups.
Yeah.
So apart from, like, do you know... dear me, I don't know how many that counts up to. That's 10 bits, 16 bits, 17 bits, 18 bits, 19 bits. You're the maths genius. What's 19 into £5? I tell you what, 20 into £1.
What, me, genius?
20 into £1 is 5 pence.
Is it?
So very approximately, I think these would have been about 25 pence each.
Wow.
Isn't that just crazy? And you could use
it.
These.
Yeah,
it's cheaper than IKEA. It's cheaper than Poundbuster, bargain basement, whatever's. Anyway, we'll have to clear this off of here and get on with the next little tranche of stuff.
Lovely.
Blue and white, yeah, blue and white. One day, blue and white will be. They'll get
the
bored of that green colour and they'll go back to blue and white.
Blue and white is the new black. Okay.
Oh, let's get into some complete change from the China. This is this was an advert of the guy David Dundas, jeans on. I got my jeans on. Except he didn't because he was in the laundrette. Is that the one?
No.
This isn't the one of the guy in the laundrette.
No,
it's something completely different. But
I've got my old blue jeans on.
Oh, yeah.
David Dundas, and the other one was Nick Kamen.
Oh, right. I'm sure that he.
No, he didn't. He wasn't in the laundrette.
Okay, but
or
I bet
dirty
he.
Dirty jeans.
I bet he wrote it so he'd get in an advert. You know, I'm sure that some of us. Anyway, that's them. There they go. This is a flexi disc. We love flexi discs. What does this say? Oh, hey, this is Smash Hits Flexi Disc.
Skids.
And it's XTC, 10 feet tall, and Skids won the Olympian. Flip to play, 33 revolutions per minute. There's another one here as well.
Mm.
What's this one? And, this is Altered Images. And I presume looking at it, you'd think that was Smash Hits as well, wouldn't it? Happy New Year, Real Toys, new version, and Leave Me Alone. And this is 33 as well. Oh, Flex. There's a weird collector's market for flexi discs. Oh, neat. This is hey, this is punk. Hey, this is a punky flexi disc. Hey, that is neat. Angelic Upstarts. The Young Ones, Wyatt Riot. Interesting. I say flexi discs, some of them are surprisingly valuable. What have we got here? We've got proper thing. Oh, do you know, I think in one thing before I was talking about the Eurythmics. I Only Want to Be With You, the Tourists. I think I Only Want to Be With You, Dusty Springfield did first. I saw them doing that song in Southampton. And the other side is Summer's Night. Never heard of that.
Mm.
By Pete Coombs. And, next thing is How Can You Live Without? Yeah, R. Tony. And Hancock's Half Hour was very funny. I don't know what this is. I bet it's got the blood donor on it. No, it hasn't. The Secret Life Of and Threatening Letters. And he was the hero from East Sheen. And he's going over there. Let's look at these big ones. I know nothing. I can't even read what that is supposed to say down there. Maybe it's supposed to say
I don't
Matthew.
Think it says anything.
No, maybe
Matthew
you're
Wilder,
right.
Break
yeah.
my stride. Yeah.
No hidden messages or anything. See, Matthew Wilder got no idea. 12 inches. They're a mystery to me, an absolute mystery. I think you've got to be DJ to understand this. It's an extended remix. It's on Epic, which might be part of CBS, I'm not sure. The next one we've got here is Stan Ridgway, Camouflage. Got no idea about this either. I presume these are probably 1980s.
One about the guy in the army who died and he came and rescued somebody and they realised he was dead afterwards.
All
camouflage.
Right.
Yeah,
I was a PFC, whatever that is, on a search patrol hunting Charlie down. It was in the jungle wars of 65. My weapon jammed and I got stuck.
That's
way
right.
out and all above. Is it? Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, well, you know that. I don't know
I
that.
I do, yeah.
And, If they haven't got an easy date, I'm not going to bother looking for it.
Camouflage.
Yeah. Oh, 1986, anyway. Mm-hmm. I always think the 80s were the classic time for 12 inches. Sing it again, Rod. Not all of us are chanting for that. This is just the one record. Or is it a double? No, it's just the one record. Mercury, brilliant condition. Sing it again, Rod, because obviously no one's played your record. I do know, I don't think anyone has played that. Oh no, I can just see, you know, I can see a few marks, scuffs across the middle, yeah. And, we love bits of Rod. Bah, bah, bah. And then, how can you not, you know, it's a race between this lot and Tony Hancock, I guess. Enrico Maricambiovitz. Was he the one who did the film music? I'm not so sure he did, though. Boom, do, ya-da-da-da, boom, do. Anyway, institution they were, weren't they? Morecambe and Wise. And then we come into, one of my... Oh, no, let's start off with, the 12-inch. Big in Japan, extended instrumental, Alphaville, WEA. On the other side, it might have something I know. Big in Japan, Alphaville. I don't really remember that, although I do remember Big in Japan, but I can't remember what their hit was. Mm. Working for the Yankee Dollar. Was that it?
Don't know.
Don't know either, not too sure. And we get on to, this old man's a bit out of his depth, let's get into something a bit safe, like Dionne Warwick, you know, and,
Scroll on by.
Scroll on by, yeah. If you see a post that you don't like, scroll on by. And that is a Sue original. I'd like you to know that. And we're going to have to write more for that, Sue. And if anyone's got any more verses to that, yeah. If you see a post that you don't like, scroll on by. Anyway, do you know the way to San Jose? She did a lovely version of that. But of course, Walk On By was, yeah. And also, anyone who had a heart, the thing that Cilla Black made her name on the back of, you know, was virtually a copy of Dionne Warwick's version. I love Dionne Warwick. Now we're going to get into something maybe a little bit unusual for me, because it's jewellery, and I don't go out of my way for jewellery, but hey, you don't often see jewellery that cheap. I like this, it was iconic. I'll put him over there,
Sue. Yes, I can see.
Yeah, I'll move him over to that bit. But dear me, he probably costs nothing and he's probably worth nothing. I don't think he's true plexiglass. I don't know though, you know.
I think he's an E-type.
Maybe he's older than I think.
He's an E-type Jag, is he?
No, I think he's a sort of, you know, a random gecko sort of 1930s roadster of some sort.
Oh.
But
I can see
he's
definitely not.
He could be 2 or 3 years old. But I think he might be 20 or 30 years old. It's just the quality of the two bits of plastic and the way the glue's discoloured. Oh, it's got to be retro glue, that. He can go over to there. This isn't what it seems, but it sure does look like it is. It looks like the most phenomenal Victorian pinchbeck or gold brooch, but hey, it isn't. You go around to the other side and you can see it's costume jewellery here. That has got a maker's mark on the top or a number or something.
Is that a bit of jet in the middle?
What about if I undo this, Sue? He's quality though, because he's got... I don't know if you can catch either of the names there. There's one at the top and one at the bottom. Can I see where's
no,
you have to go
I
back?
Can't.
You have to go back a bit. Yeah, to there. And who knows, we might be able to read that on the big screen. But it's nice to have costume jewellers with maker's marks on. You can tell some sort of quality by the quality of the catch. This has got a good fold-over catch. But I tell you what, if you had that on your coat, no one, and you told them it was your grandmother's and it was made of gold, no one would be able to tell the difference. And now we got on to something else, which is, and he's a little bit of carved plastic. And on the other side of him, they always say Scotty dogs, I never know if they're 1930s or 1950s.
I thought it was a cat.
Do you think that's a cat? No, I think it's two
whiskers,
Scotty dogs.
Has it got whiskers?
Maybe it's a cat, but dogs, can dogs have whiskers?
Well,
Yes, I don't know.
They can,
yeah. Yeah, on the back he's got foreign, and I got to really get my dates right, but that means at least pre-1972, I think, and everything that was imported had to be stamped foreign, so that we could diss it against our own stuff. Now, coming over to this one, this is Between the Wars costume jewellery. I don't know if you remember me saying, you'll have to go back and see if he focuses. I was saying, you know, you can tell quality with costume jewellery because it's got claw settings in.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously they took a hell of a lot more work, and it just does do. I should have given him a bit of a wash. He is anonymous on the back. I don't think, again, you see, he's got a nice clasp on. You know, he wasn't total sort of out of a crack of rubbish. And the green's nice, isn't it, against the brassy gold. This looks to me, it's semi-Celtic. And that's probably a piece of glass in the middle, but it might be a bit of polished, coloured up agate. But it's striving to be a much better quality than it actually is. But it's still got a really good clasp on the back.
Yeah.
You know, again, a safety clasp on. I don't think that's a name. Is it? See, just down there?
I can't see.
If I get out of the way.
I can't really see that, but...
I know.
I don't really know where
to
look.
Yeah, just, you see, they're tipping a little bit that way. Yeah, no, it didn't work, did it? And, anyway, he's nice.
Mm.
He's nice. And pins or brooches, as we call them, they haven't been that fashionable for quite a while. Here's another interesting thing in terms of a clue of quality. This has a safety chain on it. And as soon as you see that, you start thinking, well, this is a little bit better. You're also tempted to immediately turn it over and say, yeah, wonder if that's silver. But it isn't. But it is a really nice... Diamante and crystal set brooch. Absolutely beautiful. I suppose that's a spray of flowers, isn't it? You have to go back to focus. He won't get that close, will he? And, then the next bit is, I paid more than a fiver, but not much more than a fiver for this. It's that thing, isn't it? It's a motive with the leaping dolphins. And the reason why I had to pay a bit more for this is that he's actually a silver on the side there. I think he's just marked 925, not a British hallmark. He could very, very, very well be Scandinavian. A lot of these little silver brooches are. Anyway, interesting. And isn't that nice, you know? Dolphins going through the waves. And, when they're close up, they always look like comical. Oh, they look better further away. And this... is intriguing. This is going to be Indian, Tibetan. I don't think it's what they call Southwest, which is American Indian stuff, but they used a lot of turquoise. I suspect that this is low grade silver. I'll just give it the sniff test. That's going to be when I say low grade, 675, 725, something like that, I'd think. These little stones in here, I think, are only actually glass. But as an amulet, pretty nice. Anyway, it will get on my wrists are so thin now. I don't think I'm ever going to. Don't think I'm ever going to take that. Yeah, I love that. I think I'll wear that for the rest. Going to wear that for the rest of the whatever. And I think finally, the very, very last thing we got to, which was my favourite pick. Look, you can look at the front as well. You'll have to go back a bit. Yeah, and there he goes again. Absolutely lovely, and he's going to be a Dinky Toys, isn't he? Let's get him up that way. You can get the words on him.
I think that's all right for words.
Yeah, Trojan Van. I love the way, as often happens when these things have just sat, that the rubber itself, just from the weight of the little car, just goes flat. He's with just the sort of thing that that the post office would have delivered your letters in. He's going to be 1950s, isn't he? That's when he was made. And but anyway, no one is going to bother to write to me and Sue. So I guess that... well, they do. They're always sending new bills.
Yeah, that's right.
But anyway, I think that's long enough for you, I'm quite sure. We need more tea. And yeah, so it's time to say... it's time to say goodbye from me and goodbye from Sue. Sue the worker, me the big show-off. And from, bye-bye, Sue. And from the star of the show who hasn't been here, Spotty Cat. Love you all. And I hate to say it, please subscribe. Bye-bye, folks.
Oh, never throw away something you can mend. Oh, never throw away something you can mend. 'Cause your clothes should be a comfort, your clothes should be a friend. Oh, never throw away something you can mend. 'Cause the clothes that I love the best are clothes I've had for years. The clothes that I mended all the holes and rips and tears. And my clothes are full of memories, lessons that I'd learned. My clothes are full of wisdom, I didn't buy that, it was earned. And my clothes keep me dry, they keep me warm and cool. My clothes are easy, comfort is the rule. 'Cause your clothes should be a comfort, your clothes should be a friend. Oh, never throw away something you can mend. 'Cause the clothes that I love the best are clothes I've had for years. The clothes that I've mended all the holes and rips and tears. 'Cause your clothes should be a comfort, your clothes should be a friend. Oh, never throw away a friend that you can mend.